Welcome all of you in my YouTube channel Rudra Study Circle. So in this video I am going to explain maxima and minima value of function of two variable, or we say extrema value of two variable. Let z equal to f of xy. Here x and y are independent variable and z is the dependent variable. So the maxima and minima value of z is called the extrema value. Either maxima or minima value of z is called extrema value. Means this is the extrema either in the maximum or in the minimum. So extrema value of z. Fine. Okay. Now, what is the necessary condition for z? Suppose one point is given x0 in y0. So when that point is extrema point, so for that we have, let z is differential function. Z is differential function. All the partial derivative exist. Then one point x0, y is the extrema point, then partial derivative del z by del x equal to 0 and del z by del y equal to 0. This partial derivative will be 0 at the point x0, y0. Fine. So we got extrema at x0, y0 imply your partial derivative zx and zy will be 0. Fine. Now the converse is not true. Sometimes we can have partial derivative 0, but that point won't be extrema point. Okay. So the point at which partial derivative is 0, partial derivative is 0 are called the points at which the partial derivative is 0 is called stationary point. That points are called the stationary point. Okay, so all the stationary point are not the extrema point, because sometimes partial derivative is 0, but that point is not maxima and minima point, but all the extrema points are stationary point. Okay, so now working rule, let us see how to find the maxima and minima of the given function. So we'll find the maxima minima using the partial derivative concept. So first we have working rule. So first step we have, we'll solve the fx, z we have taken, okay. So we'll take the zx by del z equal to 0 and del z by del y equal to 0. We'll solve this set of equation and get the points x comma y. So these points are called the stationary point. Extrema point, stationary points. Now how we need to identify which stationary point is the extrema point. So for that we have the second derivative test. So a, let us take a equal to d2z by dx square, or we say zxx, fine. B equal to d2z by dx dy, so this we can have zxy, and c equal to d2z by dy square, so we have zyy. So we need to calculate the all three derivatives a, b, c. Then we are having AC minus B square. this is the discriminant we need to calculate. Okay, so if this is a positive at that stationary point, so we get the extrema point, and if AC minus B square less than 0 at the stationary point, so those stationary point is called the saddle points. Saddle points means at the point at which partial derivatives are 0, but it's not point of maximum minimum, it's not extrema point. And if AC minus B square equal to 0, so we need further investigation, means test fail. So no conclusion for AC minus B square equal to 0, and AC minus B square less than 0, saddle points, and if this is a positive at that particular stationary point, so those points will be your extrema point. Now out of the extrema point, which one is the maxima point and which one is the minima point, that will decide based on the A sign. Okay, so what we do, if A is positive at that particular stationary point, so that is your minima point, and corresponding value of Z will be minima value. This is the minima point at which your A is positive, and corresponding Z will be minima value, right? Okay, and if A is less than 0, so that will be your maxima point, and corresponding Z value will be maximum value. So this is the working rule, it's very simple. First you find the partial derivative and find the stationary point. Now for identify this stationary point, which is the extrema point, we need to go for second derivative test. So we find that A zxx, B zxy, and C zyy. So we find the discriminant at all stationary point, AC minus B square greater than 0, and AC minus B square less than 0, AC and B square equal to 0. So less than 0, saddle points means a point at which we have partial derivative 0, but those points are not maximum minima points, and this is the no conclusion. So when this is a positive, at that point are extrema point, and that will decide which one is the maxima, which is the minima, based on the A sign. If A is positive, so minima point, and A is negative, so maxima point. Fine. Okay, let us take one example so it will be clear. These steps, I'll take one function, then we'll see how to find the maxima and minima point of the given function. So we have f equal to we have x cube plus y cube minus 6xy. This is a given function. The question is, find the extrema point of the given function. Fine. So what is that working procedure? First one, we have fx equal to partial differentiation of f with respect to x. So y will be constant, so we get 3x square minus 6y, this equal to 0, and f of y will be partial differentiation of f with respect to y, so that will be your 3y square minus 6x equal to 0. So first we'll try to solve this equation. So we get x square minus 2y equal to 0, and second equation will be y square minus 3x equal to 0. Fine? Okay. So here from the first equation, your y is nothing but x square by 2. Substitute here. So we get x power 4 minus x for here 2 will come, sorry. 2. So x power 4 by 4 minus 2x equal to 0. So we get x power 4 minus 8x equal to 0. So x cube minus 8 equal to 0. So x equal to 0 and x equal to 2. So there are two value of x, x equal to 0 and x equal to 2. And corresponding x equal to 0 means we can get from here y will be 0. So for x equal to 0, your y is 0 and x equal to 2. X equal to 2, so your y will be y equal to 4 square by 2, again 2 only, y equal to 2. So there are two points, 0, 0 and 2, 2 is the stationary point, okay, at which partial derivatives are 0. Now go for the second derivative test and identify which point is the maximum point and which point is the minimum point. Fine, okay. So we will go a equal to f xx. So f xx will be, come here, so we get 6x minus 0, because this y is a constant. Let us find the b equal to f xy with respect to y. So if you come here, this is 0 minus 6, minus 6, fine. And c you go f yy. So f yy means this one 6y, 6y, right? Okay, so the condition, let us find the condition we have. AC minus B square. We need to identify this discriminant at each stationary point. Okay, so AC will be 36xy minus 6 whole square. So it should be 36xy minus 36. Right? Now at 0, 0, so let us say this is the D, discriminant D. Okay. So this D will be 0, D will be, okay, so we will find out the discriminant. So your D will be AC minus B square. So this is your 36xy minus 36. Now D at 0, 0. So that is your minus 36, negative. So we say the saddle points, right? At this point, your derivative is 0, partial derivative is 0, but it's not point of maximum minima, right? Now D at 2, 2. So we have 36 and 4 minus 36, right? One, zero, 8. So this is the positive. So D is the positive at 2, 2. So your 2, 2 is the extrema point. Now this extrema point is the maximum point or minimum point. How to identify? Based on the A sign, right? A equal to your F xx equal to 6x. Now this 6x, x equal to 2. So this we get 12. So 12 is positive. So your 2, 2 point is the minima point, because your A is positive here, right? A is positive here, minima point. So now your minima value f, we will find out the f equal to, it was x cube plus y cube minus 6xy. So your minima value will be f 2 comma 2 equal to 8 plus 8 minus 24, so minus 8. So for this problem, minus 8 is the minima value and 2 comma 2 is the minima point, and 2 0 0 is the saddle points of the given problem. So here I end my video. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.